Guys, that's not Catamaran Impi.
Right, let's try that again. Take two. Now this is Catamaran Impi. Well, hi everybody, and welcome to Impi, your friendly catamaran. So those of you that follow us will know that we are a couple sailing around the world, having left South Africa a number of years ago now. Okay folks, now whilst I realize you were all expecting to see our visit to Uvia in the Loyalty Islands, those who follow our travels will also know that we have been engaged in trying to help an abandoned island dog called Moose. Now whilst formalities for a flying vet to attend to Moose were being attended to by Anna, Impi anchored here in close proximity at an anchorage called Bonans in Baie de Prony. Okay, so let's get back to Moose for a while. Moose is a fantastic dog. Not only is he a survivor, he dives for fish, he digs for sea cucumbers, and he charms people. Let's go back a little in time here. Our first visit to Moose, the abandoned island dog, was shot in this footage, and it was during the first visit to New Caledonia.
So here we are on Ile de Cassie, Casey Island I call it. And we were told about this dog which has been abandoned with the island, but he looks in really good condition and our sailing friends all feed this dog. And we were told to please feed this dog when we arrive at the island. And there he is. What a cute boy. Hello boy. What is your name?
Well, one abandoned dog, but looks very happy and obviously being fed by a lot of sailors who cruise in here.
Yeah, and you know, Moose was just in excellent shape. And he had incredible energy. He really impressed us when we first met him here. Yeah, and Moose would take us for these guided tours of his island. He displayed an incredible desire to be playful, especially every time we came to a beach. You will recall how, as it was getting late in the afternoon, he would suddenly pretend to be lost, kind of like he wanted us to sleep there with him.
So we were a little bit lost on this island. That was incredible.
Then it was time to say goodbye. Oh man. We felt terrible, so we said goodbye again. And again.
Goodbye, my boy. It's nice to see you, hey? Yes. Oh. So nice to visit you and to see you. Such a good boy. Yes. Oh, the poor guy.
Yeah, and the following morning, we were tempted to go ahead and depart for Ile de Pa. But come morning, our hearts melted. We lowered the dinghy for just one more goodbye.
We're smiling because Cassie knew we were on this yacht, so he brought a coconut to play with us again. Because yesterday we played with a coconut on the beach. Brought him some breakfast. It's our farewell to him. We hope many sailors are going to come and visit here. He loves company. He loves attention. He's a fantastic dog, very friendly. So we encourage all our sailing friends, come to Cassie Island and feed Cassie the dog, man. Take him for a run on the beach, throw a few coconuts around and have a good time with him. We're actually very sad to be leaving him. He's a terrific dog, amazing nature, incredibly intelligent. And he's got that in him, you know. He can guide you down pathways and show you the way to go. Then when it gets towards evening, he suddenly loses his way, as if he wants to keep you on the island. So all of a sudden he doesn't know where to take you, and he'll take you all the wrong ways. So he's got that in him. But a fantastic dog, man.
Oh, man. Well, we struggled to say goodbye. We told the dog that we would be back next year, but in our hearts we knew that the chances for a second visit to New Caledonia would be slim to none. We really love these islands. We would love to see them a second time. But you know, it's not always practical to return when one is sailing around the world.
Right, so that's us. We're done at Cassie Island. People really do love this dog. We don't know why the local people haven't come across with their boats and somebody taken him and given him a home. You know, we were thinking maybe he has a whole island to himself. He enjoys roaming this island. People just feel, why take that away from him? Still, it would be nice if somebody would move on to Cassie Island. Why nobody lives here? There's an infrastructure here. And that would be really great for the dog too.
Call me Soppy. That dog just crept into my heart, man. Incredible. An island dog, surviving, fishing, eating crabs, eating...
Okay, so we've arrived at New Caledonia, man. We can actually see the waves breaking against the back of the reef. It's going to be very difficult to get on the GoPro, but we can see Amadee Lighthouse. Amadee Lighthouse here, you know.
Oh, oui. J'aime ou la pain au chocolat?
J'aime le pain au chocolat.
Ah, j'aime le pain. Chocolat.
Au chocolat.
Ah, j'aime le pain au chocolat. Merci beaucoup, Anna.
After 2 days in Noumea, completing formalities and restocking the boat, our first destination is Ilo Cassie in the Baie de Prony, to revisit our good friend Moose, of course. As we arrived, we shouted his name. Moose! Moose! He looked at us, wagged his tail, and promptly jumped into the water, swimming towards us. I panicked, as we still had the mainsail up, and the engines were turning. Oh dear, I hope he won't get caught up in the props.
It's just amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, swimming to the boat, huh?
As we arrive, we quickly get into the dinghy to go and say hello to our good old friend. But within minutes, it's clear to us that Moose is not the same dog as a year ago. He is very thin. He is hungry. He limps. And his eyes are sort of glazed over a bit. When we cuddle him and ruffle his ears, he cries.
Now, since so many friends and followers have asked us to visit Moose and let them know how he was doing, we put up a post on Facebook about Moose's plight. The response was overwhelming, with folks asking us to please set up a funding site for him, to look after him. Now, the thing about some of these islands is that internet is not always easy to get, and it is very expensive. But Anna was determined. There she was climbing up the mast in the late afternoon, settling into the stack pack, and she remained there until 4 a.m. the following morning, disturbing my much-needed peace with every moment that the internet bombed out. Well, I got to know that this was going to be serious business.
The number you have dialed has been changed. The new number is...
Yep, serious business it was. We soon learnt that the folks who follow our travels are truly amazing people. They actually put their money where their mouth is. Within no time at all, we had raised enough money through the GoFundMe site which Anna has set up. Moose was going now to get the attention he deserves.
We made contact with Protection du Lagon, who talked to us about a vet called Guy Kane. This is no ordinary vet, as he has a microlight and he flies into islands to help animals. Protection du Lagon promised us that they would call him. What we didn't know, however, at this point was that Guy was on holiday, on a well-deserved holiday, and that we would have to wait a few weeks.
So we're here in Guy Kane's veterinary practice. We have been waiting for a month for this man to come back from his holiday.
I never take such long holidays. This is the first time in my life, but
I know, and
it was great.
He's finally back. But he's finally back. This is his first day back, and I'm really grateful that he's made the time to see us. And we've been discussing Moose's health, so I've been explaining the symptoms that we've seen, and maybe you can just tell us what you think needs to be done next.
Yeah, well, apparently he's suffering because he's shaking. That's really a solid sign that he's suffering. There are now, there is medicine with one pill that can relieve the pain for a full month that I've been using for years, and I've never had a problem with it. It seems pretty safe to me. It could be very convenient for him. We'll see if he's a good candidate for that. I take a blood sample first to make sure that he doesn't have heartworm, which is a possibility, to make sure that his kidneys and liver is functioning fine, listen to his heart. He looks like he's in pretty good general shape for a dog that doesn't really have an owner.
For living wild, he looks good.
It shows that the island life is probably doing him a lot of good.
Well, that's one of the reasons why we don't want to bring him here.
Yeah, I can, I mean, absolutely, he's much better. He's probably happier than my dog stays in my garden. So look at his eyes, look at his ears. So may need a treatment with his ears. Look at his teeth. It's maybe 5 hours by boat, but it's 20 minutes in my seaplane, so I can have fun at the same time.
So yes, so Guy has got a hydroplane, and the idea is that he's going to fly in on Monday next week at 10 o'clock. So Impi will be leaving on Sunday afternoon, because we need 5 hours, but he needs 20 minutes, as you heard. And so we will be there to see the plane land, and then we will take clips of the treatment and post that for you. And I would just already like to thank Isabella here, because she's been driving me around to find this elusive man. And thank you, Guy, for seeing us today and for agreeing to come out on Monday. It's really great.
So whilst Anna was busy planning how to get Moose the help that he needs, other folks living in Noumea were really calling out to assist us. Mostly these were people we had engaged with on Facebook, Instagram, or YouTube, and it was just incredible to receive the support of all of you sharing Impi's journey with us. We mentioned Isabella, who drove Anna and I from place to place. We also met an incredible family who gave us their mooring close to the town centre so that we could easily reach the vet and take our time to sort things out. A young lady called Coralie and her dad Terry, who have become amazing friends to us. Oh, and here is some of the footage of when we first met them.
It's been your granddad. I thought it was your dad.
I thought you looked much bigger in the shoulders.
These guys are awesome, man. They've been very involved with Moose Moose, the abandoned dog.
Because he said
very good
yeah.
dog. And they brought us. Look at this, guys. Look at this.
Wow.
We want more people like this to visit Impi. Huh? You take note, people.
We are so grateful to the good folks of New Caledonia. We were invited to drinks on Terry's catamaran, where we actually ended up having a feast. Awesome people from an awesome island. Yeah, so we had been back and forth between Noumea and Cassie Island. Anna was engaged in getting Moose sorted out. The vet Guy Kane had set a date to arrive at Cassie Island, and we were beyond anxious to get a verdict on his health so we could cruise to some of the other islands and so forth. Sailing between the mountains was great for smooth water, but not so great for wind shifts, which had us constantly adjusting and tweaking the sails, especially going through Passage Woudin. Still, here in New Caledonia, Impi is happier than happy. These truly are amazing cruising grounds for sailors. But just as everything feels like a well-put plan coming together, the weather turns. Just the day before Guy is due to fly in, we are now fearing the worst. Would he maybe cancel this flight? And would this be a further delay for care for Moose?
Yeah, man, so it's pouring with rain. We've had quite a wet cruise down here to Cassie Island. We've arrived and Moose heard the engines as we pulled in, and there he sits on the dock.
Well, fortunately, we'd figured that Moose enjoys his fish, and we had been fishing for the lad. So, having been quite successful at this fishing, we had plenty of food for him. Now, people often ask us why we throw a towel over the fish when we land them, and really this does three things for us. First, it protects the boat from a fish thrashing about with a steel hook in his mouth, which damages gel coat. And secondly, it causes the fish to immediately relax. Somehow the fish gets a false sense of comfort being covered. And thirdly, we are able to do the kill in a more controlled environment, which causes less suffering for the fish and also no blood spatter all over the boat. But more about fishing in our videos to follow, where we sailed from the Loyalty Islands and down the east coast of New Caledonia. Yeah, and needless to say, Moose was getting his fair share in fish now, and we hoped this would energize him. So finally the day was at hand. The rain had disappeared, the sun was shining, we had clear skies, and we were so excited that Moose was finally going to get that attention that he needed. Our good friends Michael and Iris on sailing vessel Andromeda had come around to help give us a hand with the arrival of the flying vet. The weather had cleared and Guy Kane had called to advise us it was all a go. In the meanwhile and on the dock, we were trying to keep Moose occupied so that he would not go walkabout. It was important for us to have Moose there when Guy Kane arrived. Moose, give her a kiss. Are you waiting anxiously there, love? I think the difficult part for me was that I had hardened my heart toward animals after losing a pet dog at a young age. It really stung. I swore never to open my heart to animals again. Yet this dog had managed to break through every barrier I had. It really surprised me. Now Anna and I have received comments from folks asking what all the fuss is about for one dog. when so many human beings are suffering in the world. And yes, we do understand this, but unless we start caring for all living things around us, how can we truly care for each other? Caring starts with the little things we can do. It starts with sharing our lives with others. It starts with us doing our bit to bring a smile to as many faces as possible in an otherwise harsh and difficult world. To care for the oceans, to care for the planet, the animals, and all people who live from it. But wait a minute, what is that behind Impi's mast there? Ah, the flying vet has arrived. To do a fly past as well as a nearby landing, however he advised a mandatory 300 meter range from the shoreline and had to comply with this, unfortunately. I thought I should share this. Iris also took footage when Guy initially flew by. I thought it was great how she captured Moose staring at this yellow machine with terrific interest, you know. He wondered what this thing was. Little did he know that it was there to help him.
Everybody's looking. Moose wants to know who's there too.
So I was quite interested in Guy's flying machine here. The plane is a Zen Air. The company manufacturing them is based in Missouri in America. And Guy says the plane is assembled as a homemade kit. The floats of the plane are also Zen Air, but they are manufactured in Canada. The engine is an Aviation Rotax 912 and delivers about 80 horsepower, with the beauty about it being that it runs on regular unleaded petrol. It cruises at about 110 kilometers per hour and has a consumption of roughly 12 liters per hour. The plane holds 80 liters of fuel, which gives Guy a flight time of about 5 hours and extends to a range of about 550 kilometers, depending on conditions. The real trick with a plane is Guy tells me it's yellow, and that makes it really fast.
Guy, how was the flight here, man?
Oh, great.
It was good?
Yeah, very good, yeah.
Do you know we have been waiting for this man? He is very popular and a very famous and loves animals. We love this man, man.
That's because this dog's a VIP, that's why.
Ah, the dog's a VIP. I love that, man.
A VID, actually.
A VID. Yeah. A very important dog.
Yep, a very important dog indeed. And here Anna and Guy discussed the day and the plans for treatment in what I refer to as what must be one of the best surgeries in the world. Thank you. Yeah, it wasn't easy watching Moose having to go through this. There were some tough moments, but Guy Kane sure knows his stuff, and he was very thorough. So one of the first symptoms for us with Moose were his eyes, which were very cloudy. Now Guy explained that this was due to tiny electric ants who leave acid in the grass, and when dogs walk through the grass, this acid burns their eyes. There is no treatment for this, but the good doctor says it will heal with time. So Anna has a number of follow-up prescriptions for Moose. And yes, speaking of Moose, well, while he finds himself again after being heavily doped, let's get a diagnosis from Dr. Guy Kane.
Okay, so we're with Guy Kane, right Guy? It's Guy Kane and the flying vet who has come in here especially to treat Moose. And Anna has been raising money for Moose and the treatment of Moose. And Guy has been incredibly kind to just come out and attend to him.
Well, we've given him quite a few shots, some vaccines, and I understand they are for two diseases.
Yeah.
Can you just explain
right.
to us?
So we took a blood sample to check on four diseases.
Okay.
He's lucky he only has one of them, and apparently it doesn't seem too severe. He's positive for heartworm, but relatively mild heartworm.
Mm-hmm.
My experience with a dog that doesn't have a heart murmur, with the treatment I've given him, the few heartworm that he may have in his heart today, they'll just die of old age.
Okay.
In about a year.
Mm-hmm.
The medicine will act a full year, so I only have to come back and give him a shot every year for heartworm. So I'm
okay.
willing to do that, no problem.
Okay, that's
as long
really
as I'm
cool.
able. Such a nice dog.
So Guy, the visit today was actually very good then. It was a positive move from a heartworm point of view.
Yeah, if the heartworm continued, I mean, we see a lot of dogs dying from heartworm, so it was absolutely life-saving to start treating him for heartworm today. So I've given pills to Anna to in case he has a reaction to the treatment, because the medicine will kill millions of larvae of heartworm, and some dogs it goes very well, but some dogs they can feel pretty bad.
Okay.
And so anyway, I'm in contact with Anna in case there's a problem. He also got the regular vaccination for leptospirosis in particular. Leptospirosis being a major concern in New Caledonia. So that vaccination can also save his life, because on this island, obviously there are rats, because there are signs of rats in the coconuts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And so they could very well carry leptospirosis, and the vaccine then again can also save his life. So.
So the rats can also cause disease for dogs, and we have seen some coconuts have been eaten, like rats have eaten them. So
Rats are the major carrier of leptospirosis in the world. Among there are other animals as well. Here in New Caledonia, horses and cattle carry leptospirosis quite often. And they can, they're not necessarily sick with it, but they can excrete it in their urine.
Okay.
A lot of New Caledonians know about that, and so they have to watch out when you walk barefoot or even with flip-flops, and in case of any symptoms, to get treatment fast.
Okay.
Dogs are particularly exposed because they're close to the ground and they tend to drink stagnating water. And from what I understand, he drinks stagnating water.
Yeah, I think so.
He doesn't have a choice.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's really exposed to that. And the vaccine can really help save his life.
And Guy, from Moose to you, how long have you been a flying vet, I should say?
Well, I've been passionate about flying ever since I was a kid.
Yeah.
I actually applied for professional pilot and for vet at the same time when I finished high school.
Wow. You knew you were going to be a flying vet?
No. I wanted to be a pilot, and then I also considered being a vet. I didn't know up to the last minute, and then by chance, the forms didn't arrive at the pilot school, but the forms did arrive at vet school, so I became a vet.
Wow.
And now I do both, yeah. So
now
I'm
you're
really
doing an incredible amount of volunteer work, right? I mean,
yeah.
And you have associations that you work with?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. I mean, I think that these people, they're the real heroes. They really need to be interviewed. I can present these ladies. They concentrate their whole life and their energy to saving animals, and they do that every day, and they take risks.
And are they funded for this, or?
They have absolutely no funding. I know one lady, she does paint artwork that she sells on the markets, and all the money goes into her association.
To looking after animals.
24 hours a day.
Wow.
She has back problems. She's walking with a cane, and she goes into the tribes, and she finds dogs that need treating, and she brings them to me, and we take care of them. But we're often limited by the funding.
Yeah.
Even though I do cost price for the associations, well, still need a little bit of funding, and so we concentrate for the moment practically only on injuries and on sterilizations. For the moment, they don't have the funding for worming, for vaccination. Moose is very, very lucky. He's a really, really
well, thanks to all of you guys.
Yeah.
And Anna's really been pushing a lot. And
all of the donors, all of the sponsors. Moose can be a little bit like the star who is in front of the social media and who can raise money for all of these other pets.
Associations.
Who are not being looked after very well.
Yeah.
And maybe there's some education as well that can be done to the local people,
because
I think the way they view animals is very different maybe to the way we have been brought up to care for our animals.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of education to be done, you know.
Yeah, for sure, yeah, every day. I mean, I live that every day. People bring in animals. This weekend I had one dog, it was covered in motor oil, no owner. They brought it in and I just take care of it. When I'm lucky, I ask the association if they want to take part in the treatment, because of course, I do have a private practice on the side. I can't do only this
kind
of work.
Yeah.
He also brought in a dog gunned down by a car. No owner. We took care of it. Emergency treatment.
Mm.
It ended up dying, but...
still try.
Yeah. Every day we have life-threatening diseases and problems to solve and saving lives every day. That's for sure.
Talking about saving lives, one of the reasons why we're not going to have an extended interview today is because two fishermen are missing and Guy is going to go up in his plane and try to spot them. So it's not just about animals, we're also trying to help people who are lost at sea, people who want to enjoy the sea and its creatures, because Guy also goes out with his plane to spot whales and then gives that information to the whale watchers. So there's a lot of stuff that this man does, and I'm very grateful to him. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Guy is now going to be leaving us, and he's going to be searching for people lost in the lagoon area on their boat for, what, Guy, the last 2 days?
Yeah, apparently
Friday,
they were lost
contact.
Since Friday, yeah.
So there you are. He's going to go and do some other work. So we mustn't hold the man up, but thank you to all you guys who have made this possible. We really appreciate it. Guy's a great guy. He does as much as he can out of his own pocket, and it's not possible to do everything out of your own pocket. So you guys made it happen. Thanks, guys. Folks, we have started a new campaign called Help Us to Help Others. We set up an online store via the Amazon affiliate program. Anything you purchase through our link with Amazon costs you no additional money, yet drops a small percentage into our fund, Help Us to Help Others.